Hello, my name is Curtis Salgado. I'm a soul singer, rhythm and blues recording artist out of Portland, Oregon, and my love is soul music and blues and jazz and gospel. And listen to this voice right here. You don't hear this a lot.
There goes my used to be.
His name is Willie Walker.
Oh, walking down the street.
They just don't make it like this anymore. Soul singer that's still going strong in Minneapolis, and he needs to make another record to put him on the map. And Rick Estrin and Ken Anderson are hoping to do that very thing. So please support us, and let's put Willie Walker on the map. They just don't make him like that, and that is pure, deep Southern soul. Thank you.
When Rick and I got Willie Walker up to jam with the Nightcats on the legendary Rhythm and Blues Cruise last October, almost nobody in the crowd knew who he was. After being on Gold Wax Records with soul legends like James Carr and Spencer Wiggins, and having 45s out on the legendary Chess label, Willie Walker had been away from music for a long time until recently. And the big surprise is, he is as good as ever.
Bring it to me. Bring your sweet love. Bring it on home to me. Yeah. I know I laughed when you left. But now I know that I'm
Willie Walker is quite possibly and actually probably the greatest living soul singer in the world today.
I got a new project in my life, which is an old project. I started over 50 years ago, and now I've run into some new friends who are interested in what I'm doing and appreciate the way I present it. And we're working on a new CD. For me, Wee Willie Walker, a.k.a. Willie Walker. And I'm proud to have Rick and Curtis and the Nightcats working on this project with me, who the front runners. It's going to be a good time, and I hope you're on board, too. Thank you.
I used to, you know, hunt for 45s. Anyway, this particular time, I found a 45 by Willie. Was You're Running Too Fast, backed with You Name It, I've Had It. Some deep, deep soul. So that really hipped me to what Willie Walker was all about, and I'm very honored to be a part of his upcoming recording project.
You know. Women to love me, I've had some to use me, I've had money, yeah, just like a millionaire. I didn't have a worry, I didn't have a care.
He still looks the same, and he sounds the same. It's been, you know, 35 years or something since he made those records, and his voice sounds just as beautiful as it did back then.
Rick introduced me to Willie at Famous Dave's in Minneapolis, and he's made records with bands there. He's made a few records with a band called the Butanes, and they're excellent. You know, sadly, they haven't gotten the attention that, you know, a talent like Willie should get. And it's a crime. At least to me it is. So we just really want to do everything we can do with the resources we have, and they're pretty good. but we also need the resources you have so we can really put Willie Walker where he belongs on a map of American music today.
He's just, languishing in obscurity, you know. It's absurd, and it's almost tragic. So, to me it is, because I love that kind of music. I love music and people like that. You know, he's every bit as good as somebody like Solomon Burke or, Wilson Pickett. He's right up there with Johnny Taylor and Sam Cooke and guys like that. He's that kind of singer. And he still sounds the same. So, what we're doing, myself and Kid Anderson, was Kid's idea. We should just... Maybe it was my idea. Anyway, we're going to make a record. We just want to be able to pay for the creation of this record. You know, pay the musicians and stuff like that, and the expenses. We just want to do this because it needs to be done, and it really needs to be done. So we have Willie coming out here, and we're going to do it. It would be really great if we could get funding for it.
I'm gonna do it. There's no stopping this. I mean, there's only one person can stop this. And when the lights go off, they're off. But as long as the lights are on, I gotta sing. And that's a rap.
On the CD, it's gonna get done no matter what. All the guys that we have involved so far are not in it to get paid. Now, it would be great if we could pay them something. And there's other expenses that we're gonna have that nobody has volunteered yet. We're gonna need a horn section. And we're gonna need to print the CD. We're gonna need design. We're gonna need, most importantly, we're gonna need to get it out there. We're gonna need a publicist who mails all the CDs out, gets it played on the radio, gets it out to you, the public. And those things aren't free. So that's what's gonna make it, matter and make it a success, in the larger scale. You already have the support of internationally recognized talent. But in order for it to really be all that it can be, we need money.
You have to pay attention to your blessings when they come around. Meeting those guys was truly a blessing. And if you don't recognize your blessings, you can't count them. And we miss so many throughout the course of a day. I mean, most people don't even think about the good things that are happening to them on a daily basis. I mean, they don't recognize it as a blessing, because it really is. And meeting those guys are truly one of my blessings.